I'm DJ Premier, and I present to you, So What's Up?
Okay, computer. Run it back.
So What's Up?
Oh yeah, we're going special delivery today. This is a banger right here. All of my bangers, but this one's special right here. I'ma go in different stages as I always do. First of all, this is a Gangstar episode, so it's always special. Rest in peace to the great guru, Gifted Unlimited Rhymes Universal. Shout out to Big Shug, the co-founder of Gangstar, and shout out to all the foundational members. You know what I'm saying? You are loved forever. So, 1998 was the release of our first gold album ever in our career. Moment of truth. Yes, indeed. This is a special album right here for so many reasons. One of them, Guru was facing prison time over a few charges that had come to plague him during our career. Plus, we had taken a 4-year break, which is rare for people like artists of our cloth to come back strong and still be able to rock out. When it came to Moment of Truth, we hadn't dropped an album since Hard to Earn, which was dropped in 94. You know, we had other projects going on. We reunited to make this one, but here's the special part. When we were doing the recording halfway through, you know, Guru had already started making a list of people he wanted on the album. Two of the artists that he wanted came from the legendary, iconic Wu-Tang Clan, and that is Raekwon the Chef and Ghostface Killah. I said, I'll make the call, see what we could do to get them on the album. They were smoking hot, as they always are. But we got a call from our homie and family member from 183rd in the Boogie Down Bronx, and part of our Gangstar family as well. He goes by the name of Panchi of the group The NYGs. Stay tuned for that. Panchi was incarcerated at the time, and we were just giving him ideas of what we're gonna be doing. He happened to talk to Guru on the phone from behind the wall, and when he told him they were gonna get Ray and Ghost, he said, yo, we all love Ray and Ghost, cause you know they hold it down for those streets. He said, but for Guru and the collab with a Wu-Tang member, I think you should get Inspector Deck. And Guru was like, you know what, I like that idea. I reached out to the RZA. The RZA made the connection with us to talk to Inspector Deck. I'm telling you, Deck this, Deck that, Wu-Tang this, Wu-Tang that. Let's talk about where it comes from, the song. Above the Clouds. Ooh-wee. You see that disc right there? It's burning my fingertips, because this is definitely one of the illest songs that I'm so proud that I made. Okay, now that you know the name of it, when the call went through, I'll never forget, it was short and simple. When I put them on the phone, I let them talk. Inspector Deck goes, yo, what's the song about? And Guru goes, you're mental. Almost like he was in a trance, you're mental. Deck goes, that's it? He goes, yeah. He goes, got it. I'll meet you down at D&D. Shout out to Eddie Sancho, our engineer. For those that are sleeping under a whole bunch of rocks after over 20 episodes, these sounds that I'm about to speak on are contained on these floppy disks, which is why we salute these, which go into a specific machine called the Akai S950 sampler. And then from there, it's transferred to a MIDI jack, which makes them read each other's language on an MPC 60, also made by Akai. Then I assign the sounds to pads to where I get to get my program on to make the sounds that are contained here that you hear once it's all completed and laid down to 2-inch tape. We weren't digital yet, we weren't Pro Tools, we are still recording to tape. With digital, you can undo it with just, you know, one little command. With 2-inch tape, if you accidentally mess up on a punch or just even a recording, it's gone. You gotta redo it again, and just hopefully you can nail it the way you thought it was supposed to be before you erased it. All of this is going down to make a song of this level. And again, Inspector Deck was the opener of Protect Your Neck. So as soon as we heard him, we were like, yo, this kid is ill. Shout out to the whole Wu-Tang Clan, they're all ill. But Deck had a standout style, and I love his voice. I'm really into textures of voices. And once they met up and he came to D&D, the way the board was, like any studio back in the 90s, if this was the board, and this is the vocal booth window, Inspector Deck was on this end, facing that way. Guru was on this end, facing that way, and they're sitting there writing. Now, for me as a DJ, certain songs that like this one, I know I gotta have a dope intro. Got to. So I'm already thinking intro with my headphones on, looking for things to set it off before the beat drops. Another key thing that kept coming to my mind as far as the creative side was I wanted to sound like Microphone Fiend by Eric B and Rakim at the beginning of the record after the you start hearing a I said, I gotta do something just like that. There's a way to do it without being a biter because we don't condone biting. But I said, I'm gonna do something like that, which has now become a trademark for certain records I've done, especially Full Clip, and especially this one, which was the first time I ever did it. So they're writing, I've got my headphones on in a whole different world. I'm just letting the beat run. I'm in a whole different world coming up with the intro because I'm just like, this thing's gotta be crazy. They're sitting there going, and then, Deck might go, yo, how many more bars you got? And the guru look up and go, maybe like 8, a little less. He's like, all right, me too. They go back to writing. Guru, yo, how many more bars you got? He's like, I'm about down to 4, almost 3. All right, me too. They're writing. Both of them look up and go, I'm done. And he said, me too. He said, who wants to go first? Guru said, let me sing my rhyme. He did a piece of his rhyme. Deck said, yours sounds like the opener. Let me do the one to follow up. Right around that same time, I said, yo, I think I got the intro. Let me let y'all hear it. I play them the intro. And they were like, that's the intro. Let's get it. When you insert this disc right here into that S950, this is how the intro went. And here is it right now.
It has come to our attention that a mysterious force is loose somewhere in outer space.
The mysteries of creation are there.
Up in the sky?
Up in the sky.
The moon and the planets are there. And new hopes for knowledge and peace are there. And therefore, as we set sail, we ask God's blessing on the most hazardous and dangerous and greatest adventure on which man has ever embarked.
Shall bring disaster to evil factors. Demonic chapters shall be captured by kings.
I'll never forget, man, when we did that record, we were like, everybody's going to go bananas for this when this drops. And they did. It's one of our biggest records to date. It's one of the biggest records, period, in our career. And is one of the main ones I'm highly proud of. Above the Clouds. And, you know, again, rest in peace to Guru, Gangstar.Global for the Above the Clouds t-shirts. And again, salute the floppy disk. And that's what's up.
When we die hard, they build a monument to honor us with. Humongous effect in the world, we could have conquered it.
Above the clouds, where the sounds are original. Infinite skills create miracles. Warrior spiritual. Above the clouds, raining down, holding it down.